The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, 16th chapter, text number 26 through 30, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on January 23, 1974, in Hawaii.
Oh. Dharitri, the earthly planet, was lamenting that due to the contamination done by the Kali, I have lost of all these good qualities. So, Shaucham, Sattvam, truthfulness. We must remember always that we are part and parcel of God. So, we have all the good qualities of God. That is our nature. Just like the drop of the ocean water, it has got all the qualities of the ocean. There is no doubt about it. Therefore, even if we take a little drop of ocean water, because the ocean water is salty, we taste the water salty. The salt is there also, but in minute quantity. The ocean has got millions and trillions of tons of salt, and here in the drop of the water there is a grain of salt. But salt is there. Another example, just like a little portion of gold. So, that is also gold. It is not iron. So naturally, in our original position, we have got all the good qualities of God. Now, due to the material contamination, the godly qualities are now covered. The godly qualities are there, but it is cover. That covering is possible due to our very minuteness, very small quantity. Therefore we are fallible. But Krishna is not fallible. Another example, big fire and the spark. The spark is also fire, but it has got the potency to become extinguished. Suppose a spark falls down from the original fire, down, it is extinguished. But the big fire does not extinguish. Therefore, the big fire or Krishna is infallible. His name is Achyuta. Infallible. The Mahabharata philosopher says that we are in Maya, and as soon as the Maya is taken away, we are God. So, we are not God, but we manifest our godly qualities when Maya is taken away. So long we are covered by Maya, our godly qualities are not manifest. But we are not God. Or you are God, but not that God, that big God, but you are a particle God. You can say, I am God, but you are not that original chief God, that you are not. This is our philosophy, and that is very genuine. How can I be God? If I am God, then why I have lost my godly qualities? Or why my godly qualities are now covered? This is very common sense. The godly qualities are there, just like a small particle of the spark, it is carbon. When it comes out of the fire, then it is extinguished. But if you put again to the fire, it is carbon, again brightened. Similarly, we are part and parcel of God, but if we fall down from the association of God, then we become appearing like material. But you are not material. It appears, that extinguished. This is simultaneously achinta bheda vetva. We are simultaneously one and different. As part and parcel in quality, we are one. But in quantity, God is great, we are small part. So, originally we have got all these qualities, satya, saucham, daya, khanti, styaga, santosha, arjuvam, arjavam, samodamastapasyamam, tithikkhoparatishtutam. Everything is there. But due to material contamination, especially in this age, Kali Yuga, the Kali Yuga is very strong, time is very strong, that even in contact, coming in contact with Krishna consciousness, they are falling. They are falling. That is due to Kali Yuga. Therefore, Madhar Dharitri, a sochami rahitam lokam, papana koli, kolina asritam. Now the Kali Yuga has come. I am thinking that I am very much disturbed that people are losing their original qualities. These qualities are not to be acquired. These qualities are there, but it is covered. Just like a sharpened knife, the cutting power is there, but when it is covered by dirt, it does not cut. So this is due to our material contamination. Therefore, we have to revive it. That sharpness, we have to revive. That is Krishna consciousness movement. If one is actually Krishna conscious, then these qualities will be visible in his person. Yashasti bhakti bhagavati akinchana sarvai gunai tatta samasate sura. That is the test. If one is actually advanced in Krishna consciousness, he will not find any fault in him. That is Krishna consciousness. Dasyasti bhakti bhagavati akinchana. If one has got unflinching faith and devotion to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Rasyasti bhakti bhagavati akinchana sarvai gunai, all the good qualities, these are the good qualities mentioned here. Sattam saucham samodam santosha arjavam sam samay. 26 good qualities of Vaishnava. These good qualities will be manifest. Then we understand, oh, here is actually a pure devotee. A pure devotee cannot be contaminated. Just like God cannot be contaminated. But we are part and parcel, a small God. We can say, God, I am God. But if you have got sense, then you will say that I am not the great God, but I am small God. That is sense. because you have got the God qualities, you are not the Supreme. That is not possible. Supreme is Supreme. Nitya Nityanam, Chaitanas Chaitananam. That is the basic injunction. That He is the chief of the eternal. So we are all eternal. Na hannate hannamane sarire. We are not lost or dead on account of annihilation of this body. That is not possible. Nitya sasatayam na hannate hannamane sarire. As God is eternal, we are also eternal. As God is sasata, we are also sasata. But small. Achinta vidave. This is our pleasure. So Krishna consciousness movement means to revive the original consciousness. If one is actually in Krishna, he is truthfulness. These are the qualities. Cleanliness. Always clean. Taking thrice bath. Cloth clean, mind clean, body clean, activities clean, desire clean, thinking clean, everything clean. No contamination. This is the test. I am doing all nasty things and I am advertising. I am advanced. What rascal, you are advanced. You are doing all nonsense and you are advanced. And they have no shame even to call them. Shameless. Shameless, even not gentleman. Cheating. And still, he is advertising, harm and harm. But a person who is actually in Krishna consciousness, or actual sadhu shastra guru vakko tinete koriya utko. We have to, just like if you go to the chemical laboratory, you are testing the characteristic in the book, there is characteristic. Even an ordinary chemical. Now they say, take for example, salt. It is called chemical naming sodium chloride. Sodium chloride. So in the book you will find sodium chloride and the characteristics. It is like this, it is like this, it is like this. The color, the taste, the composition, so many things are there. Similarly, how we are testing the purity of sodium chloride from the books. Similarly, here is the characteristic of pure devotee. Characteristic. So we test whether it is truthful. It is not truthful, sir. Then he is not pure devotee. He is doing something he promised before the spiritual master, before the deity, before the fire, no illicit sex, but he is having illicit sex. So how he is advanced? How is he advanced? He is not even truthful. The first qualification. He is unclean. Truthfulness, Souchang means very clean. Very clean means that we utter this mantra, apovitra pavitra va sarvavasthangatu piva jasmare pundarika khamsa bhaiha abhantaram suchi. Suchi. Souchang, suchi. So, the devotee must be clean inside and outside. Both. Outside cleaning by taking bath, washing the body with oil or soap or soda. And inside, inside materially, there will be no unclean things, stool, unnecessary stool. That way one must evacuate every morning and evening. if we eat more, then we have to evacuate twice. But if we eat less, then once evacuation is sufficient. It is said, yogi, bhogi and rogi. Yogi means spiritually advanced. And bhogi means materialistic. And rogi means diseased. It is a common saying. A yogi evacuates only once. That is yogi. And bhogi, because he eats more, so he evacuates twice. And one who evacuates more than twice, he is rogi, diseased. Yogi, bhogi, rogi. So everything has got routine, var, shauchan. So you will feel healthy. If you have evacuated nicely, you have washed inside and outside, taken your bath, then you will feel always refreshed. And unless you feel refreshed, you cannot very nicely chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra or Sar Krishna. Then cleanliness is required. Apavitra pavitra va. Apavitra pavitra va sarvavasthanatma. If one takes to Krishna consciousness and follows the rules and regulations, then automatically he becomes clean inside and outside. Automatically. Apavitra pavitra va. What for we are accepting initiation? In any condition, we shall be purified by chanting Hare Krishna. Cheta darpana marjana. If we chant really, there are three stages of chanting. One chanting is with offense, beginning. There are 10 kinds of offenses. We have described many times. If we chant with offense, that is one stage. If we chant offenseless, that is one stage. And if we chant pure, offenseless is not yet pure. We're trying to make offenseless, but not yet offenseless. But when there is pure chanting, that is success. Nam, namabhas, and suddhana. So our aim is, this was discussed, you'll find in Chaitanya Charitamrita, discussion between Haridas Thakur and a Brahmin. So, by chanting, you can come to the highest stage of perfection. In the beginning, there may be offenses, but if you try to avoid the offenses, then it is namabhas. Namabhas means not actually pure name, but almost pure. Namabhas and Suddhana. When one chants Suddhana, name, holy name of God, then he is on the platform of loving platform with Krishna. That is the perfectional stage. And in Namabhas stage, not in pure, marginal, between pure and offensive. That is mukti, you become mukta, liberated from material bondage. And if we chant offensively, then we remain in the material world. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has said, namakhar bahir hoy namanahi hoy. It is mechanical, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, but actually it is not Hare Krishna. Namakhar. So it must be purely chanting. But we should not be disappointed. Even impure, but therefore we must have fixed chanting process. Because we are not in the pure stage. Therefore, by force, just like a boy in the school, we had this training. In our childhood school, our teacher would ask me, you write 10 pages and write. So that means practicing 10 pages, my handwriting will be set up. See, even if you do not follow 16 down, where is the question of chanting Hare Krishna? So don't be artificial, don't be a sober, be real thing. And that is one thing. If you want real benefit of spiritual life, don't be so what. You know so what?
Yes.
In medical science, the big bottle, it is full of water only. And color is red or blue or something like that. But a real medicine does not require, real medicine does not require a so what. A small, if one can chant purified, offenseless, once Krishna now, he is free from all material bonds. Once only. Eka Krishna name jato paap hare, paapi hoye tato paap kuribare na. So, saucham. Saucham means inward cleanliness and outward cleanliness. Saucham. Inside you should be pure, pure thinking, no contamination. We should not think anyone as my enemy, everyone is friend. I am not pure, therefore I am thinking somebody as my enemy. There are so many symptoms. So chong, one should be clean inside and outside. Sattam sochang daya. That they have already explained. Daya means to become compassionate to the fallen. One who has fallen, one is in distress. So actually the whole population at the present moment, they are fallen. Krishna says, yada yada hi dharmasya glani bhavati bharati abhuthana dharmasya tadatmanam sijamaham paritranaya sadhunam vinasaya cha duskitam dharma samasthapanarthaya sambhavami jige. So at the present moment in the Kali Yuga, practically they are all demons. All demons. So, if Krishna, of course, sometimes it will come that Krishna has to come here to simply to kill the demon. That is Kalki Avatar. That is described by Jayadeva Goswami. What is that? Kesava Dhita Kalki Sarira Jaya Jagadisha Hare. Kalo dhumaketu miva kimapi karala mlechani vahani dhani kalo atikara bala mlecha. Mlecha, this word, javan, there are words in Vedic language. Mlecha javan. Javan means meat eaters. Javan. It does not mean only Europeans are javan and Americans, not Indians are not javan. No, anyone who eats meat is a javan. Javan means meat eater. And mlecha means unclean. One who does not follow Vedic principles is called mlecha. Just like, as the Mohammedans say, kafir, one who does not follow Muslim religion, they are called kafir. That is religion point of view. And the Christians say heathens, one who does not follow Christian religion, they are called heathens, is it not? Similarly, anyone who does not follow Vedic principle, he is called mlecha. So, time will come when nobody will follow Vedic principles of life. Therefore, mlecha. So, mlecha nivaha. When all the people will become mlechas, nobody following the Vedic principles. Mlecha nivaha, nidhane. At that time, there is no more preaching, simply killing. Nivaha nidhane, kalo atikarava. In this age, very fearful, not feature, but action is very fearful. So, whatever Krishna consciousness movement is going forward, it is due to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's magnanimous compassion. for the poor people suffering in this Kali Yuga. Otherwise, to become Krishna conscious is not very easy job. It's not easy job. So, those who are getting the chance of becoming Krishna conscious by the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they should not lose the opportunity. It will be suicidal. Don't fall down. It is very easy. Simply chanting my Hare Krishna mantra, not always 24 hours, although Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recommends, Kirtaniya Sadahari, always chant. That is the principle. But we cannot do that because we are so much overwhelmed by the influence of Kali. Say at least 16 rounds. Don't miss this. What is the difficulty? 16 rounds. At most it will take 2 hours. You have got 24 hours. You want to sleep. All night. Sleep. 10 hours sleep. That is not recommended. Don't sleep more than 6 hours. But they want to sleep. They want to sleep 24 hours. That is their desire. We call it you. But no, then you will be wasting time. Minimize eating, sleeping, mating and defending. When it is need, that is perfection. Because these are bodily necessities. Eating, sleeping, mating, defending, that is bodily necessities. But I am not this body. Dehinasmin yatha dehi tumo. So that realization takes time. When we are actually advancing in Krishna consciousness, we must know our duty. Sleeping not more than 6 hours, at most 8 hours. At most, those who cannot control, but not 10 hours, 12 hours, 15 hours, no. Then what is the use of? Somebody went to see one advanced devotee, and at 9 o'clock he was sleeping. And he is an advanced devotee. Isn't that? So, what kind of devotee is? Devotee must rise early in the morning by 4 o'clock. But 5 o'clock he must finish his bathing and other things. Then he takes to chanting and so on. 24 hours business must be there. Sleeping is not good. The Goswamis used to sleep only 2 hours. I also write at night, I also sleep, not more than 3 hours, but I take some time, little sleep more. Not like I don't imitate the Goswami. That is not possible. But as far as possible, everyone should try to avoid. And avoid sleeping means if we eat less, then we will avoid. Eating, sleeping. After eating, there is sleep. So if we eat more, then more sleep. If we eat less, then less sleep. Eating, sleeping, mating. And mating should be avoided. That is a great stricture. Sex life should be minimized as far as possible. Therefore, we have got this restriction. No illicit sex. Sex life, we don't say. That you cannot do. Nobody can do. Therefore, sex life means married life. A little concession. A license. Unlike you take this license. But not illicit sex. Then you'll never be able. So, eating, sleeping, mating, and defending. And defending, we are defending so many ways. But still, what is there? And the onslaught of material nature, your country is defending so nicely. But now the petrol is taken away. You cannot defend. Similarly, everything can be taken away at any moment. So depend on Krishna for defense. Avastha Rakhive Krishna. This is called surrender. Surrender means Krishna says that you surrender unto me. Sarvadharman Paritajya. Let us believe this, that Krishna is asking to surrender. Let me surrender. He must protect.